Demo mode. If you do not have a Keller Logger device, but want to try out PressureSuite Desktop, use the demo mode to simulate a device. Choose a device type to simulate. Read out generated example measurements. Or try the live measurement with simulated data. Note that configuration cannot be changed in the demo mode. End the demo mode with the stop button. Import measurements. Import shared PressureSuite measurements with file extension .json or even from our older Logger 5 software .dx5. Select one or multiple local files. An import summary shows the success or reasons for failure. The imported measurements are now available in the list of data records. Logger configuration. Change the device name or write a note to identify the device. Program the change into the device. After a while, the device time might get out of sync. Update the device time by syncing with the computer time. Now the device time is synchronized again. Let's take a closer look at the general device configuration. With circular memory, the device will overwrite the data once the memory is full. While with linear memory, the recording will stop when all the memory space has been used up. Select the channels to be recorded and determine whether the measurement should start at a specific time. Once you're happy with the settings, click Write to Device. A hint will show when the recording starts. Define the measurement interval. The calculated time until the memory will be full is displayed here. In rare cases, it makes sense to use the secondary interval in order to dampen outlier measurements and get a smoother graph. For example, this setting would take a burst of 5 measurements every 8 minutes and then store the average value. Manually start the recording if you want it to record immediately. Water calculation. Calculate the water level based on the measured water pressure. You can calculate either the height of water, the depth from the wellhead to the water surface, or the height of the water surface above sea level. For the formula, we need the hydrostatic pressure, the barometric pressure, the density, the gravity, the installation length from the top of the wellhead to the bottom of the sensor, and the wellhead height above sea level. If you measured the distance from the wellhead to the water surface, there is a helper dialog to determine the installation length. Apply to the installation length field. Barometric compensation. Some devices do not have an integrated barometer. With the barometric compensation, the barometer from another source can be imported. On the left side, there is the measurement to be compensated. On the right, you can search for the barometric measurement. Both records must be stored in PressureSuite Desktop. A preview of the compensation will be displayed in the third column. Choose whether to import only the raw barometric values or the compensated pressure value, or both. If happy with the preview, save the values into the original record. But careful, this cannot be undone. The measurement now contains the imported barometric channel. Advanced PressureSuite settings. Expand the advanced settings to customize PressureSuite Desktop even more. Select computer or network folder in which PressureSuite Desktop stores all measurement files. Rename the default channel names. The names can be defined for a specific device, all devices of a specific device type, or generally for all devices. Further information. For more information, please refer to docs.pressuresuite.com. Navigate to Cloud Interfaces for the PressureSuite Desktop section. There you find up-to-date information about new features, frequently asked questions, and the roadmap for planned features. For other questions or feedback, find our contact information in PressureSuite Desktop. Thank you.